Yeah, this is like the only flannel shirt that I have, so this is what the review is gonna get done in. What's up, guys? This is Courtney, one half of Brothers Deconstruction here, and I'm bringing you my review for Bad Times at the El Royale.
Of course, this is my general spoiler warning, so you've been warned, as always.
This movie is directed by Drew Goddard and actually has a pretty good cast of people. Chris Hemsworth being one of the biggest leads, I guess, in the movie. A couple other people whose names I just don't know, unfortunately. I'm sorry. This is another film by Drew Goddard. He directed Cabin in the Woods. This movie is basically a suspense. It's a period suspense movie. Yeah, I think that's the best title to give it. The movie is good. The movie is actually really good. It looked good. The trailer for it looked absolutely crazy. And Chris Hemsworth, his character looked crazy as well. And come to find out, his character isn't even in the movie all that much. This movie is still so interesting because these people basically check into a hotel for whatever reasons. For different reasons, actually. And the way that the story unravels and you find out why each character is in the hotel and their backstory and, you know, what type of person they are and everything like that. It was really interesting to see it play out. It almost played out like a Quentin Tarantino movie. That's one of the best compliments I can give it. It seems like a Quentin Tarantino movie. It has like once the characters go off into their different rooms, it has like the title card for room 4, room 7, this and that. And the El Royale is a hotel that's on the California-Nevada border. Like literally one side of the hotel is in Nevada, the other side is in California. It's just really, really interesting to see how the stories are interwoven and cross each other. Because it starts out, these people come in, get their rooms, everybody goes to their separate room, one character starts digging around. I've already given my spoiler warning, so John Hamm's character is like a FBI agent, I believe. He starts digging around because they got bugs implanted, but then he finds like a shit ton of other bugs in it as well. There's something that he's looking for. Dakota Johnson has her sister with her, but she's basically like kidnapped her sister. And the movie, it's a long movie. It's almost two and a half hours. Shit goes crazy kind of early in the movie when they're crisscrossing stories, because again, John Hamm's cop or FBI or CIA agent, whatever he is, he's looking for something, and his superiors tell him, hey, don't let anybody leave until you find what you're looking for, what you've been sent to look for. But he also tells them about Dakota Johnson, her character basically having kidnapped this woman, and they tell them that's not the mission. Like, stay on mission, that doesn't concern us, don't worry about it. Him being Superman, wanting to be Superman, goes in there, tries to save the day, ends up getting killed. This movie doesn't really let up after that, because it jumps around. It jumps back in time a little bit as well. So the person that stays in this room, it shows like their backstory and them being at the hotel and what they're doing now. But then it just happens to overlay with the person that stayed in the other room, or John Hamm's character doing this one thing that he was out doing. When they all kind of come together and it's like, well, shit is about to hit the fan sooner or later. And you know that because early on, Dakota Johnson's sister is shown, I don't know how young she is. I don't know how young Dakota Johnson is supposed to be. There's a scene early on when Chris Hemsworth comes across her. I'm assuming that she's supposed to be relatively young, because the relationship seems a little creepy. And we learn that Dakota basically kidnapped her sister to get away from Chris Hemsworth because he's like the leader of this cult, which I wasn't expecting. I just thought Chris Hemsworth, the way that the trailer plays out, I just thought Chris Hemsworth was this crazy ass dude that like catches all these people at the hotel and they just have a bad time. But it was way crazier than that. Like he's the leader of a he's a hippie. He's a leader of a cult. It's crazy How? And I like Chris Hemsworth's American accent, even though his Australian accent kind of came out when he was doing his monologue in a little bit. It's crazy. She kidnaps her sister to get away from him, but then after she kills John Hamm and kind of lets her, well, John Hamm lets her sister go, and she kills John Hamm. And then after that, like, she walks away to go find somebody else or go tie up, like, the clerk. Her sister calls Chris Hemsworth, basically, on the phone and tells them where she's at. And immediately it's like, this is probably gonna be a bad decision, isn't it? Boy, was it a bad decision. Like, he comes in, ties everybody up relatively early. He's playing like a game of roulette. You know, Dakota Johnson loses and he shoots her in the fucking chest. And it's like, oh, okay, there. Oh, all right, that's happening now. And it was interesting seeing it play out and these different characters kind of interact with each other. You know, a good twist. There was a really good twist involving the guy that works at the one employee that works at the hotel, who's basically the maid, or who basically cleans the hotel, runs the front desk. He's the bartender, this and that. Like, he's the only guy that works at the hotel, and it turns out that he's like a war veteran that you know, that has like severe PTSD. He thinks Jeff Bridges' character is a real priest. Hint. He's not. They even say it in the trailer. And he's just like repenting all over the place because of all the people that he killed in the war. I don't know which war it is. I don't really even have a good grasp on what year this movie takes place in. I think at some point in the somewhere in the hotel, there's a sign that says 58. It's a sign for an event, and it has the year 1958 on it. So I'm just gonna assume this takes place in the 50s, late 50s. That war background comes into play when shit hits the fan with Chris Hemsworth and Jeff Bridges basically like headbutts him and starts fighting him. And, you know, he's able to, he has an opportunity to use a gun that's falling on the ground and kind of help them out. And he does. And he just starts taking people out left and right. And it's like, where the fuck did this come from? And then you see, oh, he was an expert marksman in the fucking war. Who would have knew? I wouldn't have. So that was a really good twist in the movie. And overall, I just liked the movie, man. It was really, really, it did a really good job of portraying Chris Hemsworth as a menacing character without having him on screen too much. Yeah, I don't really want to go on too long, man. Like, the movie was really, really good. I suggest you check it out. You will have a good time watching Bad Times at the El Royale. Check out the other videos and things like that. Looks like my camera's about to die. Yeah, check out the other stuff, guys. Talk to you later.